Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. So here we have taken another sum on sectional solids. So here we have considered a cylinder with base diameter of 40 and height 60 is kept on the horizontal plane. So here I am considering a random dimension just for explanation. So this cylinder is placed on the horizontal plane as shown here. So this is how the cylinder will look. So when I convert this into orthographic view, two-dimensional view, this will be the front view, the rectangle shape. This will be the top view, perfect circle with diameter 40. And this will be the side view, which will be again a rectangle. Now further the question says, it is cut at an angle of 45 degree passing through the point 32 mm above the axis. So this distance is 32 from the base and it is cut at an angle of 45 degree. So this is how the three-dimensional block of the cylinder when cut at an angle of 45 degree will look like. So this will be the front view. This will be the top view, a circle. And this will be the side view. So this we have to draw as given in the question, front view, sectional top view and true shape of the section. So let's begin. First we will draw the horizontal straight line. This is the XY line. Now as you know, in the top view there will be a circle. So first we will mark the center point. Now the base diameter given is 40. So on scale, we'll take the radius as 20 mm. Keep the pointer on this line anywhere and draw the circle. So this will be the top view of the cylinder, which will look like a circle as shown in the image also. Now next we have to take the projections of the circle to the front view. Now as the circle doesn't have any sides, we need to divide the circle into equal parts. So you can divide the circle into 6, 8, 12 equal parts. Here I am dividing the circle into 8 equal parts as the total angle of the circle is 360. So if we want to divide the circle into 8 equal parts, each angle will be 45 degree. So here I am marking the angle points on 45 degrees and from the center I'll draw lines intersecting those points. Just I'll join the lines on the circle itself. So with this the circle is divided into 8 equal parts. I'll name these points as 1, 2, 8. Just marking of the dimension of this circle, that diameter given is 40 and radius will be 20. So here while marking the diameter, extend this line till the other end of the circle, so it will be a diameter. Now take the projection upward towards the front view from all these points. Now 6 and 4 will align, 7 and 3 are already aligned, these two points will align. So we have taken the projection upwards. Now the height of the cylinder given is 60 mm. So from the base, I'll mark the point upward 60 mm. As you know, the front view of the cylinder will be a rectangle shape. So I'll draw a line parallel here. I'll extend this towards the side view also as later on will require. Now from the base, the question given is, there is a point 32 above the base and a 45 degree line is cutting through this point. So first we will draw a reference angle of 45 degree here. So from this point, I'll just mark an angle of 45 degree. Now using roller scale, I'll take this as the reference line. So this angle is 45 degree. I'll draw from this point. So this is the cutting point. I'll draw a line dotted. So this is how the front view is cut. From bottom, the distance is 32 millimeter, which is given in the question. So this part will be visible as the upper part of the cylinder will be totally cut off. So this part only will be dark. So this bottom part will only be dark. The upper part will remain light. Now moving forward, I'll mark these points. This will be 1 dash. This will be 2 dash, 8 dash. This will be 3 dash, 7 dash. This will be 4 dash, 6 dash, and this will be 5 dash. Now as this cylinder is totally cut, this will be the top view after the section also. So this will be A, this point, cut part, this will be A dash. This second point, this will be B. So according to this, this will be B dash. I'll mark it later. This will be C, D, this will be E. Then this will be F, this point will be G, and this will be H. Now with respect to this A, we have marked this is A dash. This respective point will be H dash, B dash. This will be G dash, C dash. This will be respect to that F dash, D dash, and this will be E dash. So now from this point, we will draw the 45 degree angle line where we will draw the side view. So from this point, 90 degree point, 45 degree point. So from this point, we'll draw the perpendicular line, the 45 degree angle line. We will take all the projections from the top view towards the 45 degree angle line. We'll take each and every point. We'll take the projections of the cut part, cut line, where it is intersecting towards the left side. We'll take the projections upward towards the side view. Now here we will draw the side view. Now as you know, side view is a rectangle. We have to draw the sectional side view. Now this intersecting point G and G dash, this will be G double dash. The intersecting point A and A dash from here, this will be A double dash. B, B dash from here, this will be B double dash. Then C dash from the front view, C from the top view, intersection will be C double dash. Like that, D, D dash, intersection will be D double dash. E and E dash, intersection will be E double dash. Then F, F dash, intersection will be F double dash. And lastly, this point H dash and H, the intersection will be H double dash. So this is the sectioned part in the side view. This will be like a circle only. So with the same radius, we can draw the circle joining all these points with the compass. So this is the cut part in the side view. Now joining this part from this part dark, as you can know, this is the remaining part. After the cut part, this part will be dark. So drawing this dark, just marking of the dimension, height is 60 millimeter. This height, the center point from where the cut part is there, this is 32. Just marking the points, this is 7 dash or 7 double dash. The intersection, 8 and 6 intersection, This is 6 double dash and 8 double dash. 1 and 5 intersection, this will be 1 double dash, 5 double dash. 2 and 4 intersection. And finally, 3 intersection will be 3 double dash. Now to draw the true shape, first we will draw perpendicular line from this point. So from this point, we will draw the perpendicular line extending towards this side. Then from this point, extending. Then from this point. So wherever this cut line is attached to the front view, we will extend perpendicular lines through it. Now next step, we will draw the axis. This is XY axis. So parallel to this line, this cut line, we will draw another axis and will mark it as X dash Y dash. Now to mark the points for the true view, we'll take this distance from 1 dash to 1. We'll keep on this point and cut an arc on this line. This point will be A1. I'll mark it as A1. Then on the other line, keep the pointer here. From 8 dash to 8, I'll take the distance, keep on this point, cut on this line. This will be H1. Then 2 dash to 2 distance, keep on the same point, cut on this line. This will be B1. Then same like this, on this point, G dash to G distance, keep on this, cut an arc on its respective line. So this point will be G1. Next, from the same point till this point, 3 dash to 3, cut on this line. I'll just intersect this line, and the intersection will be C1. Then on compass, from 6 dash to 6, keep it here, cut an arc. This I'll mark it as F1. Then 4 to 4 dash, 4 dash to 4, keep on this point, cut an arc. This will be D1. And final point, from F dash to F, keep on this point, cut an arc. This will be E1. Now, as we have got all these points, we have to join these points using French curve. So try to align 3 or more than 3 points. The more points you align, the better you get the curve. So see how I have used the French curve to join these points. You can do it accordingly. Just marking the hash lines on the section part. This is the cutting part. So here. Then in the top view, as we have to show the sectional side view, sectional top view, and the true shape. So this is the true shape. Just mark them. True shape. This is the front view. This is the sectional side view. And this is the sectional top view. This is an angle 45 degree. And we are done with the sum. Thank you for watching. Do subscribe to my channel. If you have any doubts, any queries, let me know in the comment section.